You were human once. Beautiful. Why did you do it?
Out of this, Hansa. Get lost. Keep running, asshole! Out of this, Hansa. Get lost. Keep running, asshole!
Don't get involved in this, asshole. Get out of here.
Go ahead and run.
Don't come no closer, Slick.
You don't want to get no closer, Og.
About a quickie.
Cheap.
Welcome to the Detroit Automated. author and founder of the Anti-Augmentation Organization.
If you ask me, these riots are people David Sarah's fault. How can you say that? He has this air of... Eric, before you ask... No,
affair.
Your mirror has not been replaced, Mr. Jensen. He has this air of arrogance about him, this sense of superiority. People don't like arrogance. David Sarah has almost single-handedly kept the city afloat for the past 15 years. A lot of people have jobs because of him. Doesn't mean he has the right to look down on us. In fact, most people who support augmentation technology...
How may I... See you soon. What's your pleasure? Always a...
I don't have time to chat.
Yes? May I help you?
Actually, I've been told by a mutual acquaintance that it might be the other way around.
Were you followed?
I'm a professional. I know how things work. So if we can just skip Cloak and Dagger 101.
Well, you certainly look the part. Now let's see how well you can play it.
So what is it you need?
Straight to business. A rare quality these days. Tell me, are you familiar with local gangs?
More than enough to get by.
Perfect. Now I warn you, this is not the cleanest of work, but your efforts will be well compensated. An associate of mine will leave a package for you in an alley on Grand River Road. You will retrieve this package and then use it to deal with a problem of mine. Permanently.
Who's the target?
Someone who won't be missed, I assure you. A ganger that goes by the name Double T. Hangs around in an apartment near Earl's Court. It's not likely that he'll be alone. Just as it's not likely the people keeping him company will be of the pleasant sort. You can't miss him. He's got prominent and rather tasteless augmentations to his face and arms.
You're telling me you went through all this trouble to hire me, just so I can eliminate a banger?
That would be a tad overkill, I admit. No, eliminating the target with the weapon provided to you is only the first part of your assignment. Once you've dealt with Double T, I need you to sneak into Derelict Row and plant the murder weapon among the Baller's weapon stash. Unnoticed.
Kill a member of the Motor City Bangers, then plant the murder weapon in the rival gang's weapon stash. You're trying to start a war.
Hopefully.
You don't sound like a cop.
You, on the other hand, are starting to sound exactly like one. I strongly suggest you simply get on with the program.
I don't understand what you're getting out of this. It sounds to me like you're just the middleman for someone else.
You think too much, my friend. This could prove to be a source of great personal discomfort for you in the near future.
So what's the plan? You make a call and rat one of the bangers out? Then the DRBs retaliate and so on and so forth until they wipe themselves out?
Pretty much.
What about innocent casualties? These thugs aren't exactly expert marksmen, and it's pretty hard to aim from the window of a moving car. What could be worth such a risk?
I won't discuss my motives with you. I hired you to do a job. Just do it.
I need a more precise location on the target.
There's a small back alley known to the locals as Earl's Court. You can access Double T's building using the fire escape. He's in one of the apartments on the fourth floor.
So what is it I'm picking up, and where is it exactly?
There's a rather luxurious apartment complex on Grand River Road. In front of it, on the other side of the street, you'll see a door that leads to a maintenance corridor. In the first corner of that corridor, you will find a crossbow hidden amongst the trash and debris. Use it to kill Double T.
I guess that's it for now.
Thank you.